what I want us to do now is to have them not fearing us, because it's not competition like that, but to also know that there's another continent that can bring, you know, hip hop or R&B to the same level that they can. Everybody's on a mad wave, I don't even know the time. Can we bust a little wine, baby, do it for the vine? Yeah. Mommy, son of Dean, I'll see your friend of Gina. She'd be lucky I infuse, I'd be looking for Tina. What's going on, it's your boy Eugy, and right now you're tuned into the Afrocentric Show, listening to my brother, DJ Invisible. Make sure you don't go nowhere.
That's Mr. Eugy right there. He says good afternoon to everyone who's listening to Rainbow right now. We got him today.
Yep.
It's been a time, innit? It's been a minute.
I've been letting you down too much, but today I said I can't let my brother down.
Of course, but you can't, man. Definitely can't,
not
man.
Not today, bro.
I saw your Snapchat. I think last night you guys, you and Easy were going somewhere, man.
Yeah, Loughborough.
What's going on, man?
Loughborough. He had a show in Loughborough.
So
he had a shoot yesterday as well.
Oh, okay.
I don't even know if I should say that. Actually, Hold Up. You know the Hold Up song?
Yeah.
He shot the video for that yesterday.
Ooh, so exclusive right here.
Exclusive.
Straight up.
Exclusive.
Exclusive. I like that, man. Okay, Eugene.
Yes, bro.
How would you describe Eugy, the artist?
I am a, what do they say, a diaspora? Is that what they say? Diaspora, Ghanaian.
Yeah.
And I'm blending English with tree. So
I see.
I'm trying to bring my motherland tongue into my residential tongue, if I can call it that. Fuse the two of them. Win the best of both worlds.
Right, yeah. I see that. Okay, you know what? I listened to your songs. The first time I heard you, I think it was on Twitter, and then you did a little
freestyle.
It's like, whoa, who's this guy, man? Where is he coming from? Wow. And then people started retweeting and things like that. Wow, that's crazy, man. All right, let's talk about, you know, let's get to know you personal.
Okay, bro.
Okay, where about from Ghana are you from?
Dad is from Kumasi.
Okay.
Mom's from Accra.
Right.
I was born in Kolebu Hospital. Lived in Dansoman for 6 years.
Okay.
And then came over to the UK.
So you haven't lived in the UK all your life then?
No, I've lived there.
Okay. Do you go back home often?
Bro, if I'm honest, I feel very ashamed to say this, but the first time I went back since I came here was just Christmas gone.
What?
So I hadn't been back in 21 years. 21 years, man.
Wow. So how was it when you were there last Christmas?
I did not want to come back.
You know, straight up.
You know when you get home, like it feels like you're home.
Yeah.
Like you're around your people. Even with people that don't have anything there, the little that they have, they still enjoy life. They're still happy.
Okay.
It was the most humbling experience for me, man. It's crazy.
But you were here 25 years.
Yeah.
And you know, you left Ghana, I would say about 6-7 years?
Yeah, six,
okay,
seven years.
When you were 6.
So I've been there for 21 years, should I
21
say.
Years. Yeah. Okay, cool. So, I mean, how can you say Ghana was like home to you when you lived here 25 years?
Imagine you're walking and all you're hearing is the home, the language that you speak at home, or the language that your parents speak at home. So it's not like you have to go to Tottenham to a barbershop to go and hear it. You know what I'm saying? Everywhere you're walking, you're hearing the language that, you know, your family speaks. And to me, I mean, that's what made me feel at home the most, man.
Okay, yeah. Okay, cool. So, where about from London are you from?
South Kilburn originally.
Yeah?
Yeah.
What's that?
Northwest London.
Northwest?
Yeah. Like
you're presenting there, yeah? Brap.
Yeah, but now I live in Hertfordshire, man. Outside in the sticks, as they call it.
Yeah. Okay. Let me ask you this quickly. Yeah. What do you think are the major differences from living in London to living in Ghana as well?
The way of life. I think over there is more slow paced. It's more relaxed.
Right.
I'm not saying people are lazy there. It's not lazy. It's more, they have a more calmer approach to life. Over here, everything is very fast paced. It's almost like if you go and lock yourself in a room for 2 days over here, you miss out on so much. But Ghana is very slow paced. Everyone's chilled over there. So I think it's just the speed of the way of living.
You talk with a lot of passion, like, and you just went back to Ghana like Christmas after 21 years.
I'm the biggest ambassador now, bro.
So, would you ever move back permanently?
Oh, 100%. 100%.
Straight up.
100%.
You live in London?
100%.
Uja London.
I'm going, please. I'm going.
I feel you, man. This is Eugy right here on Rainbow Radio with DJ Invisible on the Afrocentric Show. I'm going to play a tune and we're going to come back and have a little chit chat, get to know about your music and stuff like that. All right, stay right here with us, don't go nowhere.
Exactly, chilling with Eugy right here. It's Rainbow Radio.
What we say, brother? What you say, man?
Bro, I'm just here catching the vibe, you know. Just catching the vibe, bro.
Yeah, Eugy is an UK Ghanaian artist based in UK. He went Ghana last Christmas,
bro.
After 21 years.
Epic.
And he's dying to go back,
I
man.
I cannot wait.
Alright, let's talk about your music. How did you get into the music industry?
So, bro, I've been rapping since I was about 13. If we say
13.
When I first, you know, fell in love with music,
yeah.
I know it was before I even came to this country. Because when I came to this country, my grandma told my dad to not ever let me stop doing music.
Wow.
I was always playing on her pots and just trying to make things happen.
Mm.
So by about 10 years old, I was playing the piano and the drums.
Okay.
Yeah, for like our church. And by 13, I was rapping. So I was pushing that. Got to about 19. Mm. And I opened up for like Trey Songz and Jay Holiday at the O2 with rapping. These guys are singers, but they booked me to open them as a rapper. And then I went into a group with my brothers.
Right.
We signed. I'll wait for you to bring
that up. We'll talk about that. It's coming.
And then the rest is history. I mean, and then it's God, really. It's God.
Okay, you know, the first time when I saw you, like I said earlier on, when I saw you doing a cover of, what song was it? One of Trey Songz.
Okay, too? Yeah, all we do.
Yeah, and then you put it on, I think, on Instagram.
Yeah,
and then you were just getting, people were just sharing.
Yeah, like, it was crazy.
And retweeting and things like that. How did you feel, man, when that happened?
The weirdest thing of it was I did this tree rap thing by mistake. I was doing it for fun. The first ever video I did was over WizKid's Cairo beat. So I did it, and when I was rapping over the beat, it was straight English, but when I was listening, I was like, no, this is an African beat, so let me put a little bit of tree in, just for fun. I did that, and then people went crazy. So everyone was like, do some more. So I did those ones, and then literally everything just took off.
And then that's it.
I didn't plan it.
You didn't plan anything?
I didn't plan this.
So that's where you got your moves, like, of doing chi and English together, just mixing it.
Just by mistake.
Wow.
Just by mistake.
And then it's taking your places, bro. Wow. So like you were talking about you and your brothers. Yeah. So at the beginning, you were in the group.
Yeah, that's right.
And they were called E3B, right?
Yeah, that's right.
Your two brothers, they sing as well?
Yeah, they sing. Yeah.
Okay, so why did you decide to pursued a solo career then?
Obviously because I think I'm a stronger rapper than I am singer. And at the stage that we were at, my brothers, they work full time at the moment.
Okay.
One of them actually has his own shop.
Right.
And he's just started the business, so
he wouldn't
have the time, you know, to be going studio and shows like that. At the same time, I'll give up everything for music.
Okay.
So I thought, let me just push this and see how far I can take it. And to be honest with you, everything that's happening, every day I wake up, it just feels like a dream.
Wow.
Because, you know, I didn't expect it to get this far. But,
wow, that's crazy, man. Yeah, man. Man, come on, man. You're blessed, man. You know, sometimes when you feel this way and then you do one, two things and then it just takes you to another level, man. I love that. Yeah. Okay, what would you say makes you unique?
The fact that I do more English than tree, because I know in the beginning people were comparing me to Sark.
But, to Sark.
Yeah, but when it comes to Sark, his tree rap is epic. Nobody can touch him.
Definitely.
With the tree side. But I think what I bring is the English
the
side
English
because
side.
I'm from the UK.
Yeah.
So I think
and you got the acid as well, so which makes it much better.
Yeah, that's right. Mm. And also that I do have the secret weapon of being able to sing as well. So
I see. You know what? Your style of rap is very calm and smooth.
Yeah.
Are you always calm and smooth in person?
Bro, when I was younger, I was wild. And the older I got, the more I realized that it wasn't going to get me anywhere. I think about maybe 5-6 years ago, that went out the window. And
oh, wow.
Yeah, I don't hype anymore. Me, I'm the first person to say sorry. And I'm always calm in situations. So I think it's as you get older, you learn.
Mm.
You learn, yeah. So.
See, so you learn and then you just like, nah.
Life lessons, man.
Yeah? So this is the other side of you, being calm.
Yeah.
And then that is actually generating
more.
Your movement.
More
it's just
love.
Taking you to places, man.
Yeah, yeah,
wow. So so what, now you talk calmly like that?
Bro, as in, I'm not stressed at all. Even if I have stress, if I can't sort the stress out, there's no point in me putting it on my shoulders like that. So number two, now, a bit controversial because I'm about to say, oh, you know, you might not promote the right thing as well. For me, Shatta Wale. He hypes differently.
Big up to Shatta, man, wherever he is, man.
Differently. And then there's also a fancy rapper. I don't think people have heard about a lot about him, but I think he's crazy. His name is T-Flow.
T-Flow?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
These are your top three, you know. Yes. What happened to Sark?
I love Sark, but I love Sark a lot.
I feel like putting you on the spot right there, man.
I love Sark. I respect him. That's like big bro, you know. Yeah, yeah, I haven't had the chance to meet him yet, but he's inspirational for me. But for me, if you're talking about, because I like stuff that, I don't know, it's weird. It's weird, but for me, those are the guys that if I say I'm going to listen to Ghanaian songs, I'll type in first. But then if you let me take the list to like five people,
right,
then it'll be Sark and Stoneboy after.
You know, okay, okay. So I feel you. T-Flow, we need to push T-Flow, yeah, man. Yeah.
Big up Lex McCarthy. He had literally, I think, 2 days.
Wow.
Or day, 2 days to get ready for that video.
Wow.
And he executed way better than I could have even imagined. My manager even left because he had to come back to UK. So he paid for everything and left. Obviously, wow. I know he was panicking.
Well, your manager was panicking.
I know he was. He didn't tell me, yeah, because he wasn't there. He wasn't sure how I was going to go. But Lex made everything run so smooth. I had some cousins over there with me still. Yeah, so yeah, when we came out with the video, everyone was just blown away.
Wow.
Even still to now, when I watch it, I'm like, wow.
Yeah, yeah. Talking about the video, check out the video on YouTube right now. It's right, called Body featuring Mr. Easy. Yep. I want to play that to you right now. No so problem. You know, everyone who's listening, this is Eugy. Yeah. Shout out to you, brother. You're large. Let's do this. I got Eugy in the building. Say something, man.
I'm here.
Exactly. I've heard this guy, Lufa.
It's my first time.
Man, it's crazy.
He's sick.
He's sick. The remix. Well, he did it. That's the, I would say, a cover of Onani with Crumbs and Flavor. Shout out to Crumbs and Flavor, man.
My brothers, big them.
Hey, they're taking over. Definitely.
Big
them
all day, my brothers.
They did a dance at Times Square in America.
Yeah, the takeover video.
What? Yeah. Crazy. Yeah, cool. What a big move. I love that.
I'm telling you.
Okay, let's talk about how you got, what you got coming this year.
Okay.
What can we expect from you 2016?
Easy and I are going to drop a joint.
Wait. Yeah. Exclusively right here. Exclusive. What did you say? You and who?
Easy, Mr. Easy.
You gonna do what?
We're gonna drop a joint. I don't know if we can call it album or mixtape or EP, but something is coming from us, a joint project.
Wow.
Yeah, we're gonna give them more.
Sounds big.
More together. And I'm gonna also drop an independent, like a solo mixtape as well.
Right.
And I'm gonna give you guys more videos.
Yeah? More videos.
Time to flood. Time to
flood the team. Wow, man. Hey, it sounds big, man. To be honest, it sounds big. It sounds like you got everything planned for the whole year now.
Bro, I have to. Bro.
Crazy. Wow. And what is the ultimate goal for you right now?
I think for me, I want us to put Africa on the map where, you know, right now we all idolize what the American rappers are American. I mean, if everyone's talking about ultimate goal, we all aim to try and crack America. But what I want us to do now is to have them not fearing us, because it's not competition like that, but to also know that there's another continent that can bring, you know, hip hop or R&B to the same level that they can. And I genuinely believe we are capable of doing it.
For real?
So yeah, easily. Wow. If you're talking about rap talent, I mean, if you listen to Sark and compare him to the best of the best over there, not a lot of them can rap the way he does. The only issue is because of the language he might be speaking half the time.
You're
they
right.
might not understand. But if talking about technicalities and rapping ability, he's up there. He's
I
up
mean,
there
he dropped drop a verse of what you're saying in one of his, I think it's freestyle.
Yeah.
And he said he wished that, you know, the world can understand what he's saying, and he'll be called one of the, you know,
he can rap as fast as
Busta,
Rhymes. He can drop flows like Drake. He can switch. I mean, he can do many rappers all in one.
Shout out to Sack, man. It's a shame that I couldn't get him, man.
He'll be back.
Hey, I'll get him. Definitely, I'll get him next time when he's in town.
Yeah.
I know he's busy. He's shutting down MK tonight. Wow, crazy, man. Crazy. I'm going to play a game with you right now.
Okay.
To play the game,
yeah.
I will say a line from a song you've released or featured on.
Okay.
Then you have to guess what's the title of the song.
Okay.
I mean, you get it, yeah? Easy, yeah, man.
Okay,
easy thing.
Okay.
All right, let's do this. Let's start with this one. Okay, he says, "Girl, I'm done thugging. All I need is your affection."
Yeah.
What song is that?
High Love. Boats Made It, Mr. Easy and your boy UG. Big up French Kiss.
French Kiss. Hey, shout out to French Kiss French in Ghana, Kiss. Man. Big up to you, brother.
Big
the
up
large.
Kiss. Yeah.
Okay, number two. I'm chilling in the corner because I'm swooning.
I know what's on.
Come on, man. I played that song here today.
It is Musa.
Oh, whoa, well done, brother. You know your thing. You know your thing.
I had to think there.
I like that, man. I like. Oh, number three. Let's go. So blessed, I was ready from beginning.
If you give me kiss, Charlie. Cheers. Chance, baby, chance.
Hey, chance. I love that, man. Hey, you know what? You're on point. You're on point. You're on point. You know your thing. All right, cool. Number four. Yeah. I'll be right over. We go vibe proper. Grabbing glass, she be wine proper.
Body for you.
I love that, man. I feel like I just gave it away, man. Because I was literally singing or rapping. Was I rapping?
You're being me, bro. I had to guess. Nah, it's crazy. Sometimes, you know, sometimes it's weird, but you can forget your own lyrics.
Yeah.
You have too many lyrics in your head. Sometimes you can even mix two, like one from one song, one from the other, especially if the flows somehow are similar. So you have to be very careful.
I feel you, man. I wish I could give you another one. Trust me. So I see how you come. Anyway, I'm so good, man. I mean, it's a blessing having you here, man.
Thank you for having
how can
me,
we
bro.
Get in touch with you all across all the social network platform and things like that?
Yeah, so Twitter and Instagram, Snapchat, it's Eugy Official. So it's Eugy and then Official. You can find me on those sites there, and also if you want to check out my videos on YouTube, just type my name Eugy on YouTube and then subscribe to my channel. You'll see some stuff on there as well, man.
Wow. Bless. Are you on Periscope as well? Have you heard about
that? I've literally just signed up like 2 days ago. I haven't actually started.
It sounds like it's a struggle, man. Every time,
you know
everyone
why?
Just...
Because there's so many to keep up with already.
You know what I mean?
Soon it's going to take over my life because one minute I'm jumping on Snap and I have to remember, yo, the Snapchat, the Twitter people don't know what I've just done on Snap. Oh, the Instagram people don't know what I've just done on Twitter. So I'm always going in a circuit. Now they want to add Periscope to it.
Oh, trust me, it's man.
I don't know what to do anymore.
I don't know, man.
I don't know, bro.
It's just crazy.
Well, you always have to stay in the loop, innit?
Trust me, man. I mean, what can we do? We just have to keep it up, innit?
I'm telling you, bro. We have to.
You know what? It's a blessing having you in the building, man. Anytime you got a new tune,
love.
Exclusively. Make sure we get first, man.
Love, bro.
Make sure we get
you
first.
You know you're there, bro. I just want to big up Team Salute, big up Jules. Big up Qualms of Flavor, J.H. Hollands, Mr. Easy.
Cool. Big up Eunice, one of your fans. She's listening.
Big up Eunice. Love you. I don't know who you are, Eunice, but love you for tuning in, babe.
Oh, good, man. Eugene, blessing, man.
Thank you for having me. Big up DJ Invisible. Congratulations on your award as well, bro.
Thank you, brother.
You thought I forgot, didn't you? Congratulations.
Thank you very much. Bless up. Bro. I'm going to play a tune. It says, Say Hot, Castro.
Let's go.
And... D-Block, let's go!